Metzner back at NAMM Show 2019. I'm standing with Rodrigo from Fender, and he's going to take us on a walk through all of these new pedals you have.
How's it going? All right, so we've got 6 brand new effects pedals that we're launching for this NAMM show, which brings us to a total of 15 in our line, which is pretty cool. We're very proud of that. So I'll just take you guys through them in a line here. The first one that we've got is the MTG, which is our first tube distortion pedal, which is really cool. You'll see that it comes in the dual foot switch form factor, and it does actually have a little tiny preamp tube inside the pedal. So you're going to get a very natural kind of rich, warm tube tone from it. As far as the controls on the front, you're going to have bass, middle, and treble tone controls, and you've got a tightness control here that'll kind of tighten up the low end depending on, you know, if you're playing in like a lower tuning or if you have a particularly bassy guitar. You have an overall level and gain control, of course. And then the boost button here can be configured to either add gain or just add a clean boost to your signal as well, too. So that's a really kind of nice, interesting feature with that pedal that we don't really have on anything else. And then moving into our modulation pedals here, we've got the Lost Highway, which is a phaser. One cool thing that you'll find on all 3 of these modulation pedals is a dynamically sensitive rate control. So basically, to explain that, you've got like a fast and a slow setting on all these pedals that you can set, and then you can toggle between the fast and slow settings using your playing based on the sensitivity knob. So if you kind of dig in, you play a little bit harder, you're going to get the faster speed. Yeah. If you kind of lay back and play a little bit quieter, you'll get the slower speed. So it kind of adds an extra dimension of liveliness into your playing and lets you kind of emphasize and exaggerate stuff here. So the Lost Highway basically has that feature where you can switch between the slow and fast settings. It has a triangle wave and a sine wave setting that you can toggle between there as well. The bubbler pedal here is a chorus and has that same dynamic sensitive rate control feature. So you have, a fast and a slow setting with independent rate and depth controls that you can set independently of each other. And you can toggle between those either using the switch or using your playing using that sensitivity knob right there. Then we go into our 2 digital pedals, which are both true stereo pedals. So we actually have these wired up here with 2 amps, so you can run them in true stereo. Good for keyboard players, good for guitar players. So the pinwheel is going to be a rotary speaker that gives you 2 different type of Leslie emulations and a Fender vibratone emulation. So this will get you all those kind of swirly, kind of rotating speaker sounds. On the back, you'll find a voicing switch that allows you to set it up either for guitar or a keyboard voicing. So both guitar and keyboard player friendly. If you're using like a full range amp or a guitar amp, you can kind of set that switch accordingly. So that's a fun one. And then the last one here is our Traverb pedal, which is really kind of the smash hit of all the ones that we're putting out at this particular show. The reason being, this is kind of all the classic effects you would find in Fender tube amps. So you've got reverb on one side, tremolo on the other. On the reverb side, you've got a 63 brown face reverb, a 65 black face deluxe reverb, and a plate reverb. On the tremolo side, you've got an optical tremolo, a bias tremolo, and a harmonic tremolo for 3 different types of trem. You can reverse the path, so you can put the reverb before the trem or vice versa. And then, of course, you've got the stereo output, too, so you can run 2 different amps simultaneously for a really nice, big, lush sound. And then finally, the last one that we've got here is the Downtown Express, which is our first bass multi-effect pedal. So basically, this is like a one-stop shop for bass players. You get EQ, overdrive, and compression all in one box. You can turn them all off and on separately, so it's kind of like having 3 individual pedals all in one. You've got an XLR output on the back. You've got a tuner output and a dedicated mute button, so you can run your tuner while being able to mute your signal from that. So that's the lineup. Those are the 6 new ones that we've got for this show.
Really excited. That's great. Thank you for your time. And if anybody has any questions about any of these amps, go ahead and leave them in the comments below.